Hi guys, welcome back to the session again. So we are going to start. We are going to resume our class what we have left yesterday. So we are going to again go through this initial phase of SQL command, how we are going to get familiar with SQL environment and what we are going to do in the SQL initial DDL and all those commands. And I'll show you what we can do in Oracle Apex, the initial setup with Oracle Apex. But before that, I want you to take you through the application again, because I was getting a lot of requests from you guys personally on my email address and in WhatsApp chat about your issues. So I just thought to let you know that where you can actually write your questions, and I'll get back to you above all your questions. So that is what I just want to show you. So that you raise your question in future developer app itself. Okay. So I hope I'm audible to all you all people, and you can see my screen.
Yes, Saurabh, you are audible and screen is visible.
Okay, fine. So I have done a little bit changes here in the application because that was not very UI friendly. I have seen that. A lot of people told me as well. So now, once you will get into this application, you'll be seeing these tabs. For you guys, you can see basic, advanced, study material, and webinar session. So these four tabs will be visible to you guys. And above that, we have home, WhatsApp group, forum, and another additional tab. I have added as COVID-19 news. You can see your the recent update on COVID-19. But if you have any question about the session, you have any technical question, you have any general question, you can raise your question here in the forum. You can directly go to the forum by clicking on this tab, or you have a button raise question. By clicking on this button also, you can go to this forum page. So once you will reach to this place, you can raise your question here. So whatever question you have, if you want, let's say you want to ask about Apex, or you want to know how many people are there in the Apex, or you want to, you have an issue in DDL commands, or you are failing to install SQL Developer, or you are failing to install database, Oracle database, or whatever issue you have, you can raise from here by clicking on this plus button. You just have to click on this plus button. It will give you a form. Yes, this form. You add your information here, and if you have any screenshot, upload your screenshot here. If you have multiple screenshots, make a zip and upload here, then create. That is it. So once you will create your question, that will get added here in this list. So me or Alok, we will come to this place and we will check how many of the people have raised their question, and we will reply you back with the same way. So that I'll let you know. So using this way, you can raise your question actually. And I ask all you guys to upload to ask your question in this forum, not in my WhatsApp personal chat or my email address, because that will help us to document your problems properly. Okay, so this is first thing I want to tell you. And the second thing what I want to show you is all the webinar sessions, whatever we are doing, you will get all webinar sessions under this webinar sessions tab. So when you will go to this place, you will be having the recorded video. As you can see here, we have yesterday we completed our session in two parts. So these two parts are uploaded here. You can click on this button and you can see the complete video what we have completed so far. And once, if you will click on this the written place, so you will go to the place where you have you will get to know what is this video about, the information of this video. Okay, and so you will get written stuff over here. So we are working on this some more stuff. We are uploading the screenshot or the written document as well. So all the documents, all the uploaded documents, you can download from here, and all the written thing you can, read from here. That is what we have made this interface. So whatever webinar sessions you will be attending, you will get information from this webinar sessions tab. So that is what I just want to tell you about this app. So now I think we are good to go. We are going to resume our classes what we left yesterday. Yeah, so till here, anyone has any doubt, any problem? Okay, it seems we are good to go. No one is having any doubt. So yeah, so Alok, should we start with SQL stuff what we left yesterday, or?
We are gonna start with that.
Yeah. Okay, so before that, I want to tell you guys one more thing, that we are going to take this session in two parts. One is first 40 minutes for SQL and PLSQL, another 40 minutes is for Oracle Apex. So this this part is going to get ended in 40 minutes. So again, you have to join the this session. So we are going to take break for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you can join this link, and we will again meet after the first session, first 40 minute session. Yes. So we can start now.
So are we gonna use the same link? This is my question.
Yes.
Are we gonna use the same link, or you are gonna post a new link?
No. We are going to use same link. Okay. What I have posted.
Okay, guys. Fine. Okay, guys. So yesterday, let's begin with the SQL, PLSQL. So some of the guys were asking in chat yesterday that when are we gonna start SQL and PLSQL. For those guys, just wanted to update you that this was our preparation for that SQL, PLSQL, what installation we did yesterday. Actually, that is what is required for classes, for SQL, PLSQL classes. Right, so we're doing it, so be aware of that. Okay, so I think you could not get why we were installing those applications, some of you. I'm not talking about all of you. And I would also like to know that whether you all people were able to install that application, or still people are facing problem. So you can just ping in the chat whether everybody was able to install that application and create the schema, connect to that SQL developer. Or one more thing, guys, we will be also sharing from the application, you will be getting all the classes, previous classes. So in case, if you are missing something in the class, or you could not ask something in the class, you can go to the video and you can have a look on that, and you can find out what exactly we did in last class. So that would be very helpful for, you guys. Okay, so I did not get any response, so I feel like you all of you were able to install that Oracle database in your system, and as well as SQL developer. So I'm going forward. See, guys, one more thing I want to say, that I will not go more into the theory part. Okay, the theory which is not required, but the theory which is required in interviews and all that, definitely I'm gonna tell you. But theory which is not required, that those things I will not be telling you. Okay, so I'll be telling you what exactly required when you go for interview, what exactly required when you get requirement in the software field. So everything which will be relevant, I'll be telling you all that. So let's okay, so I'm seeing somebody typing some message while testing user schema and SQL developer. I'm going to be listed a failure test field. Listener refused to connect with the following error. Know the SID given in the listener doesn't know currently know the SID given in the connect descriptor. Okay, so for this you will have to check into your TNS file. Okay, you will have to check that SID, the SID which you are going to use in your SQL developer is the same which is being used in TNS file. So please check that. And also you can, with this error code, this is ORA 12505. Okay, using this, you can also search on Google. This is ORA error, you can search and you can find out some solution over there. If you are unable to do that, unable to fix it, I'll just personally connect with me and then I'll help you out to, handle this issue. One more thing you can try with this thing. This thing is you can go to the services and you can restart listener. I'll tell you, you just connect with me after the session. I'll help you out. Which version actually you installed? Okay, so fine. So, okay, it's better. Like many people are waiting. So I guess like we should discuss afterwards. Okay, fine. So guys, so let me open the document yesterday where we were left. Okay, so now, so let's introduce you SQL. Though it is not very important, but for the guys who are beginning right now, for them, like it's a quick overview. Okay, so SQL basically, see, Oracle database is keeping the data, right? What is data? Any idea? So see, not everything which we are getting around us is data, right? Meaningful information is called data. Okay, so you are not saving the movie name and all in database, but you are definitely saving your bank details and relevant informations, right? So those information which are important, that is only data which you are saving into some system. Okay, so initially what was happening? Initially, like in the old times, what was happening is we were using file systems, right? You might have seen the old movies in which like there was a Munim and was keeping a file register in which like he was keeping record of everybody whom he had lended the money, right? And he was just tackling that on his own, and that file was whole and sole data keeper, right? So but what was the problem with that? If for a moment, like nowadays, you are seeing that you go to a bank and there are lakhs and lakhs customers are there, right? In that case, like if we go to save the data into the files, what do you think? How efficient it would be to find out detail of any customer in from those files, right? A million files, like you have to, for a customer, particular customer, you have to look for information, you have to go from those million files and you have to segregate, and there are a lot more chances of manual errors, right? There would be a lot of mistakes, a lot of time taking. It would not be very inefficient process to find out details, right? So that is where file system lacked, and which led to invention of RDBMS. Okay, RDBMS is relational database management system. Relational because data over here is related to each other. Okay, if table is there, if some other tables are there, some other procedures are there. Okay, so everything is like related to each other because of some logic, because of some data. So this is why it is called relational database management system. So there are different RDBMS in which Oracle is the most popular one, and you can understand the popularity of RDBMS, Oracle RDBMS is that 75% to 80% of the projects are using this database itself. Okay, so now this is why Oracle RDBMS came into the picture, because what it does, it gives you efficiency. When you have to look for data, it gives you very fast result, and there are very less chances of mistakes, okay, manual errors, and like you can write logic so that manual intervention will be very less to handle the data, right? So that is why this Oracle database came, and why SQL came because now database is there, data is being saved into that database. Now you have to communicate with that database, right? Data is kept. Now you need a language to communicate with database. What is communication with database? That is manipulation, creation, dropping of objects, right? Manipulation means insert, update, delete, those kind of activity you are doing. See, for a moment, like you have, that money has to be reduced, right? So manually that cannot be done. That is where software does that activity for you, right? Activity are being recorded into database so that like in the if you want to access those records, like what happened, you want to check that, all those things are ready into your database through your software, right? So SQL is being used as a language to communicate with database. That is why it was invented, right? Now where all it is being used, it is all being used in all over the software industry where applications are being built. I'm not saying that only Oracle database is being used. NoSQL is there. Cassandra is there. SQL. This is the most efficient one actually for this transactional database. Right now, coming to how we have seen already installation of Oracle database and connection of SQL developer with the schema means how we are going to use this. We are ready to start our coding, right? So let's come to the introduction of SQL. This is a basic introduction which maybe maybe asked by the interviewers, but usually is a structured query language. Okay, this is called a structured query language. Now, this is case insensitive. Okay. This is case insensitive means you can write in upper case or a lower case, doesn't matter, right? It will not like if you are not run in both cases equally. Okay, it is quite easier when compared to any other programming language to learn, right? Because it is English like language. If you see, it gives you idea that it is gonna update into some table, right? Delete, that also gives you idea that okay, it is gonna delete something, right? So it's a English like language, so it's most easier language to learn. It is quite easy to learn, and by seeing the word itself, you will be able of this because it is English like language. Now, what it does, as I said, it helps to communicate with database. Communicate means all sort of activity which you are doing, right? Communication means DML. DML means data manipulation language, which is insert, update, delete, which I'll be coming into. I'll be explaining those in next sessions. Now. Guys, one thing. Can you allow me to share the screen? Actually, I forgot to share, and nobody actually reminded me of that.
Yeah, I just thought that you are actually working on that, but yeah, I allowed you.
Okay, fine. Yeah. I thought I have shared. Okay, so SQL, so what it does, database, SQL, what it does, it communicates with database, right? Communication, as I said, that it can be insert, update, delete, is all is kind of, you're talking to your database, what you are going to do, you're giving command to it in SQL, right? Now, it helps to create drop database object and build logic. What it helps to create the, see, for a moment, you are gonna, yesterday I saw you in SQL developer that a lot of objects were showing up inside the schema, right? Those all, objects you have to create, right? And if you don't need that, you can drop that also. Procedure, functions, there are some database objects called procedure, functions, triggers, etc. For which like you have to build logics, right? So that also can be done using SQL and PLSQL. So this is basic intro, guys. You can keep it handy. We'll be anyway uploading this into the app. So there also you can download. Or it is already been shared in this document also. So you can refer that also. Now guys, we are gonna begin with the DDL commands. Okay, so there are in SQL, there are few commands. Okay, let me share the SQL developer first. Is it getting open? Yes. Guys, stop me if you feel like I'm going fast. Or if you feel like you have to raise some question, okay, though we have not gone very much in nothing in deep or nothing in technical, so I don't find step in and stop me. And those guys who are knowing all these things, they can have a look, if they feel like, they can wait for other sessions also. Okay. So yesterday this schema we had created. Now how to begin with this schema? Right click on this, begin with this schema. Right click on this, test one. Okay. And there is the open SQL worksheet. Remember this, open SQL worksheet. You have to open the SQL worksheet on which you will start working. Fine, so this has opened, okay, more than one has opened. Now, so there are SQL commands, guys. Okay, so before going to SQL commands, okay, let me tell you one important thing. Okay, there is one basic object which we will be anyway introducing with all different objects in SQL, SQL and PLSQL, but this is the one which is most important. Around this you will be writing all the logic, which is called table. Okay, so this is a database object which works like a storage, right? It will be keeping your all the data. Now how it will look like? It will look like exactly like a Excel data. Okay, how it looks like, one second I'll tell you. I think I will not have. Okay, so this will contain column and rows. Okay, let me open Excel. Yeah, so you can see this, it will be like this. It is record and rows, you can say, and this is like column. This will be in this format. Like for a moment, employee table is there, e name is there, salary is there. Okay, here Ram, salary is 1000 rupees. Shyam, salary is 2000 rupees. Okay, so data will look like exactly like this. Okay, inside a table. So I'll just this is just for an idea. Okay, I'm just gonna create and show you that. So now let us start. As I said that in SQL there are multiple commands, so let's begin with DDL. So first of all, like I'll tell you what all commands are there: DDL, DML, ECL.
Hello, Alu.
ECL. Yeah.
Yeah, sorry to interrupt you.
Yeah, yeah, sorry.
Actually, we are bound with time, so maybe we are having 5 minutes here. So maybe we'll have to wrap up in 5 minutes, or we will have to restart our session again if you wanna continue it. So in 5 minutes, if you wanna, you can complete. You can please complete that, or we have to restart our session after 5 minutes.
Okay, because we have not gone through SQL PLSQL, I think let's. With the
so let's
also I think
yeah so let's stop
at
here
least for DDL, like I
and we should take a question from audience now, and then we can go ahead. Till now, if they have any doubt, any problem, we can address that first, and then maybe we can go ahead.
Okay,
so guys, anyone is having any problem, any query in their head?
So it's better. I think we'll have to raise the link again, or what?
Yes, we have to raise the link again after 2 minutes, after 3 minutes actually.
Okay.
So that will be fine
okay,
for you
okay.
guys. Yeah. So we will be we'll be raising this link again. You can join our session using the same link. Okay. So we will be going to discontinue here. Please join us again after 5 minutes. Okay.
Yeah, no
okay.
problem.
Okay, everyone. Thank you so much. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you so much.
I clicked on that. I think it is started recording, right? Yeah, it is started because I'm able to see the
okay.
sign of recording. Yeah. Data definition
great,
language.
Great, yeah.
Yeah. So this is data definition language. This is data manipulation language. So these are basic commands which will be being useful in your entire programming in SQL. Okay, so keep in mind this is gonna be useful for start to end, these commands. Transaction control language. Data control language. And last is data query language. So under these, there are other SQL keywords like create, alter, truncate, drop, and rename. For this, let me insert, update, delete, and merge. These are the activity which we are doing under DDL DML, now TCM. Commit, rollback, and save point. DCL, data control language, grant and revoke. DQL will have select. Okay, so now let's begin with DDL, data definition language, create. This is the command used to create a database object. Now, what are database objects? Everything inside the database is database object, like table, procedure, function, views, okay, sequence, triggers, etc. All database object. Okay, so everything you need to create using create statement. Okay. Alter to modify the existing object. I mean, you can add this so that it becomes complete. This is the command used to modify the existing object. This is the command used to delete or remove data from a table. I told you, right? Table is a storage which will keep the data, right? To completely clean off, to completely remove the data from a table, we are gonna use truncate command. Drop to drop the database object. Okay, rename used to rename.
Hey, hello. Hey, hello. Are you sharing?
Okay, okay. Yes, I am sharing. Yeah. Are you not able to see?
Yes, Vivek, he is sharing actually. He is sharing his screen.
Actually, I am not able to see. That's right.
Oh, is that?
You are not able to see? I don't know. We are able to see his screen.
Can you do okay. one thing?
I think there is some problem in, at your end.
Yeah.
You okay, can let me check.
Try this. Yeah, disconnect and connect. No, you will get back. Okay, so rename. This is the command used to rename the database object. Okay. So now, starting with create. Guys, stop me wherever you get any kind of confusion. Now, see, I'll start, see, create, I'll be starting with the table. Okay, and later on, whenever I'm teaching you, like, training you about the views, procedure, function, there I'll use the create statement to create those objects also. But here I will use to create the database object such as table. Create table, say any name, test, column, call one. I want to create a number field. Okay, number, column two, worker. Now guys, we'll be explaining anyway this data types. Okay, for now I want to just tell you, if you have to define a column of number field, like employee number, right? Employee number can be 1, 2, 3, 4. That will not have an alphabet. Okay, that will not be alphanumeric. Okay, so that will be a numeric field. Okay, so for that data type you can define as number. For the column in which you have to provide a string can be alphabets or alphanumeric. Okay, so there you have to provide varchar. For the column where you are going to provide the date related info, there you have to use date data type. Okay, so what three data types which are the most important? Date, number, and worker. Okay, so now here you have, it is mandatory, and with the number you have option to provide the length of the number, but it is not mandatory. But with the string you have to provide how long string you wanna, what should be the limit of length. Okay, so I am giving 10. Now so table test created, right? This is how you can create a table. So this is one way to create a table. Syntax, let me write the syntax again. Syntax, this is because just an example. Syntax is create table, table name, column, name, data type. Okay, column name 2, data type you have to provide. Okay, and so on. So this is one way to create a table. Another syntax, say there is a, now there is a table called test already available in the schema test 1. I want to create a replica of that table. How to create a replica of that table? I can use create table set. Okay. create table, paste, say 3, add. I have to copy, create a copy of another table, add, select, star, from, paste, and just execute it. So test 3 created. If you want to see inside the table, how you can see that, anyway, I'm going to tell you in data query language, but as of now, you just see this, select star from test. It doesn't contain any data. It will not return any data, but it will return the column name. So column 1 and column 2, it is showing up. If it has data, what it will show? It will show the data. For now, I will anyway explain insert, but I will insert some value into it. Paste. Okay. Column 1, I am giving a number value. Column 2, as I said, a string is there. So I am giving it something. Okay. Okay, so there, or anyway, I'll explain you. So one row has been inserted into table test. Now if I want to see the record, so column 1 contains 1, column 2 contains Ram, right? If I have created this table, let's drop this table and recreate, and let's see data is being copied or not. Drop table, list 3. Okay. So now I am recreating the same table and I want to see that whether data is being copied or not. So table test 3 has been created. Let's see test 3. So test 3 is also having the same values, right? So guys, if you want to create a copy of a table, you have to create with this syntax, right? Create table, table name, table, table name as select star from table name 2. Okay. Now, again, there are, you know, if you for a moment, if you want to select the particular column, you can use here that column name instead of a star. Okay. Okay. One thing I want to tell you, okay, if you do select a star from some table name, okay, you will get all the columns of that table. You will get whatever columns are available. What are the columns available over here? Column 1 and column 2. Okay. Similarly, if employee table is there, what all columns can be there? Employee name, salary, employee number, right? Department. All those details will be available over there, right? So those columns can be used. So this is another format. If you want to add the column, what you need to do? You will just use this. Select only column 1 you want. One more thing I want to tell you guys, inside the database, you cannot create objects with same names. I mean, two different objects cannot be created with the same name. Okay, because it maintains, RDBMS maintain uniqueness across the schema. Okay, if you are trying to create the, see, for a moment, if I'm trying to create this table, what will happen? Test 3 is already available in the schema and I'm trying to create a schema, this table again. What it is saying? Name is already used by existing object, right? So it will not allow you to create the duplicate object with the same name. So I am changing this and I'm just using one column in the select statement. Test 4 has been created. Table test 4 has been created. If you want to see the table, select star from test 4. See, one extra. See, one more thing is there. You have to be very careful while typing. If you are giving a, you know, any mistake, if you are doing it while typing or any extra character is being added, it will throw an error. So now you can see that only one column it has selected and it has created a table test 4 with one column. Okay, so you have to, according to requirement or however your requirement is coming up, accordingly, if you want to create the table, you have to find out what all columns are required. If it is, they are saying for a moment your requirement comes like all columns should come from the test or another table, then you use direct star. Okay. Don't use column then, because that will be impacting on the performance of the query. Okay, performance is the, you know, advanced topic. Anyway, when I'll explain you these things, I'll explain you there also. Okay, so if you have to use all the columns of a table to create a new table, that time use star instead of that column name. If you have to create a table with particular column, then use that particular column itself. Okay, now this is a replica. You are creating the replica. Many times you will have to create the backup of a table. That time this query will be, you will be using for support, all support and you know, support activities. You, this is very much a useful query and being used by all sort of support guys. Now for a moment, if I have to create a table and I don't want the data to be copied, what I can do, we can write like this: create table name as select star from table name 2 where 1 is equal to 2. Guys, with the select statement, where comes that again is a topic which I'll be explaining you when I'll be going through DQL select statement. Okay, so there for the filtering condition, we use where clause. Okay, where clause, here you provide a condition and it will check into the table whether this condition fulfills. Okay, so as of now, you just keep in mind. Okay, when I will be teaching you where clause, and then I'll explain you this thing also. Okay, so this is the script to create copy of a table without data. So create table test5 at select star from test where 1 is equal to 2. So what 1 is equal to 2? 1 cannot be equal to 2. So this is a false condition. So with false condition, whatever condition you give over here, if that is true, then only it will be fetching some record that always, you know, for a moment, a table is there called employee. Okay, that has employee name Ram. Okay. And we are just giving here where employee name is equal to Ram. So that will match that record and it will return us that record, right? But if there is no Ram and we are giving where employee name is equal to Ram, it will not return us any record. Similarly, because that condition is not fulfilled, that condition is not correct, that condition is not matching to the records available into that database, into that table. So this is not, that is not returning any record to us. Similarly, over here, 1 is equal to, when we use, that time this condition is false because 1 cannot be equal to 2. So in this condition, it is not going to take any record from that particular table. So if you want to copy, if you want to create a replica of a table without its data available, then you have to go with this syntax. Okay, test 5 has been created. Now let us see whether test 5 contains any data. So there is no data, right? So if you want to create a replica of a table, with a replica means duplicate of a table without its data, then you go for this syntax. So these are the create create syntax. Now going for the another syntax, alter. Now we have a test column, right? Okay, so for a moment we have a table called test, which has some data, right? And now a requirement came that okay, we need another one more column to be added to the test table. Okay, in that like some other data will be getting saved. Like that, some requirement came from in your project. So what you are gonna do? You are gonna use alter statement. Like for a moment, add column into a table. What is the syntax? Alter table test add all three number column I want to add. Okay. What it is saying? Table test altered. So guys, one more thing I want to say, whether you people got how I am executing these records. Guys, can you ping and tell me whether you are getting that how I am running these records? I mean, it is question for those guys who are entirely new for this session. Maybe I might have not paid attention on this part, if they are knowing or not. So guys, okay, it's okay, fine. So let me tell you, you can run this along with this run statement. You can see that this is you have to select this script and you have to run with this. Okay. So already, so right now I again executed it. So what it is saying, column being added already exists in the table. Okay, so let's see whether table, column got added to that table. Select start from list table. You can see that column 3 has been added. Now, if I have to add multiple columns, what we are going to do? Column 4. Column 5. Table test altered. Let's start from test. You can see that 4, 5 also got added. So if you have to add one column, use this syntax. If you have to add multiple column, use this syntax. Also, right now I have given example for number, but you can change it. You can also use varchar. Saurabh, I think this session again prompting a message that it is being ended in 10 minutes. Sorry. Saurabh, are you able to hear me?
Yes, Alok, yes.
Yeah, so this is saying it is gonna end in 10 minutes again.
Yeah, so I think now we should wrap up the SQL part here. Okay. And we should ask to people if they have any problem, any doubt. till till here. So
okay.
Please raise your question, guys. No doubt from Manik.
Okay. Okay, guys, if you have any doubt, please raise the question over here.
Great. So are you guys, are you going to have, you want me to take session for Apex now, or you all are for PLSQL here? Ravi is saying no doubt. That is fine, Ravi. How many of you are for Oracle Apex here?
So Manik is there.
Manik is for Apex. Yes. Kartikeyan is also interested. Steven. Mm-hmm. I think only three people are here for Apex.
Okay, but as per the schedule, I guess
Pooja is also here.
Okay.
Vivek.
So guys, maybe today, like, we could not finish what we had targeted, but from next class onward, we'll be going faster, and from the starting itself, without wasting time in having a word for database or anything else, we will be technically, like, we will be trying to finish SQL PLSQL part as fast as possible. Okay, so that we could be able to cover more content in a session, as I'm seeing that I'm unable to contribute that much for today. Okay, so let's because people are also, the session is scheduled for Apex also from this time onwards. So I think, Saurav, what do you say? Shall we start with Apex?
Yes, I think we should start with Apex now. So
yeah, guys, who want to continue?
You guys have to reconnect us again.
Okay, it is gonna disconnect again.
Yes.
Okay.
Because our time bound is for 40 minutes only. This issue we are facing only for this time. Next time onwards, we are going to solve this problem. We don't have to disconnect again and again. We are going to find some, you know, better way to have this session. So bear with us for this session, and we are assuring you that you are not going to face this issue again